Hello everyone, moving charges and magnetism part 4, torque on current loop, magnetic dipole. In this video, we shall be discussing a torque on rectangular current loop in a uniform magnetic field. For that, we can consider a current loop ABCD kept in a uniform magnetic field. The current loop is having length B and breadth A, and the uniform magnetic field is given by B. Due to this uniform magnetic field, these sides AB and CD experiences a force. Now the force on arm AB directed into the plane of the loop F1 is given by IB into capital B. Besides, AD and CB does not experience any force as they are parallel to the direction of the magnetic field. Now the force on CD similarly given by F2 is equal to IBB, which is equal to F1. Since the direction of these two forces are equal and opposite, the net force on loop is zero. Both these forces constitute a couple as shown in the figure B, and M is the magnetic moment which is acting at a distance of A by 2 from F1 and F2. Thus, the torque on the loop tends to rotate it anti-clockwise, and the torque tau can be calculated as F1 into A by 2 plus F2 into A by 2, which is equal to I into B into A into B, where A into B is the area of the rectangular loop. Hence, torque becomes IAB. In this case, the rectangular loop is kept parallel to the magnetic field. Now, if the rectangular loop is kept at an angle theta to the direction of the magnetic field, as shown in this figure A, then the angle between the magnetic moment vector and the magnetic field is theta. Since the perpendicular distance of the couple is reduced, the intensity of the torque is also reduced in this case. In this case, the torque experienced by the current loop is given by tau is equal to F1 A by 2 sin theta plus F2 A by 2 sin theta, which on further simplification becomes I capital A B sin theta, where A is the area of the rectangular loop, I is the current flowing through the loop, B is the magnetic field, and theta is the angle between the magnetic field and the moment vector. Now, magnetic moment of the current loop M is the product of current and the area vector. Therefore, tau is equal to the dot product of magnetic moment vector and the magnetic field vector. This is analogous to the case of torque in the case of an electric field. For n turns of current loop, the total magnetic moment is equal to n times Ia. Now we can see the circular current loop as a magnetic dipole. In this case also, this is analogous to the dipole that we saw in the case of electric field. For a circular current loop of radius r carrying a steady current, the magnetic field produced along its axis B is equal to mu 0 I r square by 2 into x square plus r square the whole raised to 3 by 2. This was discussed in the previous video. Now let us consider the case when the value of x is very much greater than r, the radius of the loop. In this case, the magnetic field B is equal to mu 0 I R square divided by 2x cube. Now, area of the loop is given by pi capital R square. Therefore, B is equal to mu 0 I A by 2 pi x cube. That is, B is equal to mu 0 M by 2 pi x cube. Or B is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi 2 M by x cube. Where M is the magnetic moment and mu 0 by 4 pi is a constant and x is the distance from the origin of the circular loop. Now you can see the magnetic dipole of a revolving electron. In the case of a revolving electron, a current is produced due to its motion. So, due to this current, also, a magnetic field is produced. Now, according to Bohr's theory, an atom consists of a heavy positive nucleus at the center around which electrons revolve as the planets revolve around the sun. In this case, the force is Coulomb's force. Now the current due to the revolving electron I is equal to E by T, where E is the charge of the electron and T is the time period of the revolution. And time period is given by 2 pi R by V, where R is the radius of the orbit and V is the orbital velocity. Therefore, I can be written as EV by 2 pi R. Now the magnetic moment mu L in this case is equal to I pi R square, that is IA, which becomes EVR by 2. Now we multiply both the numerator and denominator by ME, which is the mass of the electron. And now MEVR is the angular momentum. Hence, the equation becomes E by 2ME into L, where L is the angular momentum of the electron. So, mu L is equal to vectorically negative E by 2ME vector L. In this case, this negative, since the electron is negatively charged, mu L by L is a constant known as the gyromagnetic ratio, which is equivalent to 8.8 into 10 raised to 10 coulomb per kilogram. So this is the end of this video. In this video, I have mainly discussed the concept of torque experienced by a current carrying loop in a magnetic field and also the magnetic dipole. If you have got any doubt, please comment in the section below. Thank you.